The David Feldman radio program is made possible by listeners like you. You sad, pathetic humps.
You're supposed to point your finger at me so I know. Have we started yet? How am I doing? How's the show going so far? I think it's going pretty well. It's awful already?
Yeah,
I haven't even...
Lacey and I left three times. Alan ran down the stairs to get us.
I haven't even done the introduction yet, and already the show sucks.
Jesus Christ.
Okay, can only be downhill from here. Hello, welcome to the broadcast. I'm David Feldman, davidfeldmanshow.com. Please friend me on Facebook.
Please don't.
Follow me on Twitter. Subscribe to the show on iTunes, please, or Stitcher, and give us a good review. That helps us move up the charts. And I don't even know what that means. I was told to say that. Up the charts.
Up the charts.
And we have a YouTube channel, which I'm obsessing on. We only get like...
What could you possibly film, Feldman, that anyone would want to see?
Well, it's audio.
It's an audio. Okay.
It's audio.
You don't do makeup tutorials?
Hey, guys. We're going to look flirty, but not ostentatious today. I'm going to do some crystal meth while I'm doing this just to punch up my teeth. So
I'd subscribe. Subscribe.
I'm kind of obsessing on the YouTube channel this year. I'll introduce our guest in a second.
Oh, my God.
So subscribe to my YouTube channel because I think...
Lacey left.
So did I.
I left my body. I'm physically here. Physically, she's here, unfortunately.
I'm thinking of how to go viral. YouTube seems to be one of the best ways to go viral. So we have a YouTube channel. It's just audio. Right now, I think we get like 40 views, 100 views.
Well, your first problem is that it's audio. YouTube's a visual platform.
Let me introduce my guests.
Oh, my God.
Kristen Buckels is here. She's no stranger to this show. Just a stranger to success, love, and...
Wow.
I opening shot. Opening salvo.
Shots fired. Shots fired. Shots fired.
Shots fired.
Yeah, let's really spell it out for Feldman today.
I'm hard of hearing.
Kristen
Buckels. We love Kristen Buckels. Every time she does the show, people say, how come you just have her on the show and not...
Everyone's confused why I'm here.
No, people love you. And is she your partner? Lacey Jeka?
Yes. Legally, we're married. That's true.
You're kind of a team, right?
Kind of.
You're a writing team.
Yeah, yes. We're a team. We're a team in love and comedy and life
and trendsetting and entrepreneurship.
We're trendsetters.
Now,
chase makers.
Lacey. And my goal here is to divide and conquer. Break
us
you two up.
Up.
Yeah,
nope.
That's how I work here.
It's literally impossible, but,
try.
Now, Lacey has a great intro.
Wow. Yeah. Wait, this might work. He's complimenting me. I'm easy.
Lacey,
I'm easy.
Jeka.
Go ahead.
This is the intro that came off her press sheet. Lacey Jeka. Is
as
a
he
writer.
Mispronounces your first name. Here we go.
Lacey. Is it Lacey?
It's not.
Is your middle name Fair? Lacey Fair?
Oh, Jesus Christ.
It's going to get worse, by the way.
All downhill.
This is just the beginning of the bad jokes that shut. I mean, it's.
Love that in comedy.
Yeah, yeah. Don't you?
Lacey Jeka is a writer, comedian, whose credits include.
Oh, my God. Please
comedian.
Don't. Comedian.
What?
I would never spell comedian with an E and an
That's
E.
That's the dumbest shit in the world.
Are you transitioning from a comedian to a comedian?
Oh my God.
I don't understand.
Comedian is so outdated.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, it's so outdated.
That's like saying stewardess. Like,
yeah.
Please don't.
Stop. Just say, what's wrong with you?
Like a doctor's still a doctor. You know what I mean? It's just why is there a difference?
So when I'm on a plane... And I see what used to be a stewardess. I just call her a male flight attendant. Is that what I'm supposed to do?
He's a lunatic.
The serial killer.
Oh, male flight attendant. Yeah. Yes, may I help you?
No, it's just steward.
Steward?
It's just flight attendant.
But how do I identify that person's gender?
Why do you need to identify their gender?
That's the way I was brought up. You say, I'm polite. I know people
Feldman,
are. I know gender is fluid. So
when
what I do is, what are you?
No.
The first thing I say is, what are you?
When you first brought me the show, you were like, I'm an old dog and I need to learn new tricks. Here's your new trick, Feldman. Dance.
Never
okay?
Dance out of this room.
Dance out of this room so Lacey and I can have some peace.
My friend Jane came up with a funny title for my show, whenever I have young people on. Get on my lawn. Isn't that brilliant?
Buckels hated it.
Huh?
I liked it. Buckels hated how much you enjoyed it, so she refused laughter.
Lacey, I have the worst poker face in the world, and it makes Lacey uncomfortable.
I'm too polite.
So you don't think it's important to know what a person's sex is or their...
In their in how they describe their occupation or their hobbies? No.
No. Like, comedienne is the most annoying
infuriating
thing. If there is any... Lacey and I have decided if there is a open mic or somebody who refers to themselves in their show as comedienne, sassy, bitchy, baby...
Sassy?
God.
If anyone ever called me sassy to my face, they'd be dead.
I'll put a gun to your head.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much.
Love you so
much. Love you so much.
You two are spitfires.
Mm.
Is that a bad word to call
No, I like that. No, that was fun.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. I thought spitfire would be insulting.
That's enough, though.
Don't keep saying it. It's like when you keep saying a word and it sounds weirder the more you say it. Don't.
That's plenty. And we're done. No more, please.
All right. So, Lacey Jeka is a writer, comedian.
Mm.
Now, here's my problem with
Oh, my God. I'm never going to get...
I wrote an amazing intro.
That's a male term.
Comedian?
Yeah.
Why?
Says who? Alan, Google it.
Is doctress a thing? Why?
Doctress. That sounds so fucking stupid.
Yeah. Why? Why is that just
why
comedy?
Why is comedian a
By
male
the way,
term?
I rather... If I'm looking through my healthcare plan and I saw a doctress...
Sweet Jesus, it's about to get awful.
I would pick a doctress over a doctor. Because statistics show that if you have a female doctor, you're going to live. A new study came out that shows
I actually did see that.
Go ahead. Talk about it.
I saw that it's like you're expected. I don't know that it's that a female doctor tends to have like clients or patients of a longer lifespan than males. That's... I read the title.
I believe that.
I think that, and this is, you know, I'm going to get into trouble, but you know what? I'm already in trouble.
Always.
I'm always in trouble.
Yeah.
I am.
Look at him, folks. Big dumb animal.
Dig it.
There you go.
I'm a hit.
You're a hit.
I'm going to be, I'm just going to make a sweeping statement.
Just say it.
Oh, I think women make better doctors.
Uh-huh.
And they make horrible divorce attorneys.
Oh. God, you really harp on this divorce joke.
I do. I just do.
Let it go.
We know you're divorced.
We get it. Okay, you're old. Whatever.
I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why.
What?
I'm going to get into trouble saying this, but women...
Can you stop prefacing everything you say?
That's my... It's
his thing.
So many people have said that
to me. It's his brand.
Yeah. What, Alex? I'm all over the map?
No. Hello. I agree with them.
About prefacing?
Yes.
Because I'm...
Thank you so much.
Because I'm abused.
Oh.
Life has abused me.
Oh, he's a victim, you guys. Oh, my God.
He's so sweet.
Aw, you're so squishy. Hate him so much.
He's so handsome.
Wow. We killed him.
Wow.
Literally murdered him in his own home.
I feel like that's what I do with my animals. I verbally abuse them that way.
Oh, yeah. I love talking shit to animals.
Absolutely. You're so stupid.
And people get upset.
Really?
No, but why?
Yeah, people get upset.
As long as the animal's not getting upset.
Yeah, they're fine. If you say it in a nice voice, they love it.
Yeah.
No, people say, they know you're sick. They know.
Okay.
Yeah. Ah, fuck them.
Please.
I say, you know what? You have a hostile womb. That's why you are so hostile towards me when I talk to you. And that's to men I say that to. I say, you have a hostile womb, you can't have kids, so you think this mutt is your child, and it's a, can I say, I don't want to say retarded.
But he does.
Don't want to say that, okay. But I will. Okay.
Lacey, oh my God. I don't want to be all over the map here today. And that's why, and I'm going to make a generalization that female divorce attorneys are all over the map, and they're charging you by the hour. They never get to the point.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a male guy, a mailman.
Wait, can I just say for the
Correct.
Record, though?
Yes,
he's a man
mailman.
And he's a male.
No. Here's why I will tell you, I will defend a female divorce attorney, not that I have any experience. A female divorce attorney will stay on the phone with you and explain to you exactly what's going on within the hour and charge you for the hour. The male will tell you just the fucking cliff notes in 5 minutes and still charge you for the hour.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Well, all right.
I would love to hear my credits.
Oh. I would love to hear those out loud.
Okay. I need to get my arms around this show.
I'm sorry?
I think I don't like to be all over the map. I've been listening to podcasts, and there's no through line on most of them.
Right.
And this show, the point of this show today.
Sorry.
Okay. Now I have to make a note about women belching because
I love you so much.
Is it wrong to
She was getting so worked up, like, this is what I want for my show.
Okay, is it I have told a woman I love who's younger than I am.
Okay.
Much younger.
Okay.
That women do not pass gas around men.
Have you ever watched Sex in the City?
So funny. That's the stupidest thing.
And I was told that's the wrong thing to tell a young person.
Isn't that an equal sort of a thing? Don't usually men and women, when they're courting each other, don't want to do that for like several weeks?
Yeah.
Isn't that fair to say?
I'd say for several weeks, but I mean, like, once
eventually.
My relationship, we're long gone. Like, yeah, it's just
we've been together for years, though.
Yeah.
Okay. My generation, you know, separate bathrooms for black people and white people. That's my generation.
I hate this place.
Get me out. My stomach hurts. I'm nauseous.
That's my generation. All right, Lacey, check. So my listeners, I promise you, there's a through line to this. Let me tell you what this show is about.
The shocking part, he has listeners.
Most of them are in my head. Okay. The purpose of today's show is I am getting articles off my desk. I've done some New Year cleaning,
mm-hmm.
and I have articles I've been meaning to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm going to crumble them up and throw them out after I read the headlines. And I can say, okay, there was a purpose to printing this out.
We're here to clean up Feldman's garbage.
We get the garbage.
We're taking out the trash.
Great.
Awesome. Well, we're just a chore.
Lacey Jeka is a writer comedian.
Thank you. That was dangerous.
You can say it a little more.
Whose female casual. Credits include the Chris Gethard show. He's a man. A show starring two men, Oh Hello, on Broadway.
Two white men.
Colin Quinn's Netflix special, The New York Story. She's a triple threat, a threat to others, herself, and she models.
I model.
Oh, hang on. I read it.
What?
Read my credits.
Wait. It's interesting how you emphasize, I actually read this.
Uh-huh.
Listen to how I read this, and I thought you were serious. Listen to what I said.
Okay.
This is how I read it. She is a triple threat, mm-hmm. a threat to others, herself, and she models. I swear to God.
I'm a threat to she models. That's how diseased I am. Yes.
I love that.
I swear to God, I thought you were like, you hurt she models.
Oh, is that so interesting, Lacey?
Is that crazy?
Kill me.
Isn't Feldman fucked?
Isn't Feldman just the craziest?
So
quirky.
Get me out of here.
So you don't hurt she models.
I don't.
You are a model.
I'm neither. I don't know.
Okay, pass.
It's just a joke. Bye. Never mind. I'm sorry you brought it up.
So you model.
I don't.
It's a joke, Feldman.
Oh.
Okay. Follow her on Instagram.
Thank you.
At Lacey MTJ.
That's right.
What does the T stand for?
Teresa. It's my middle name.
Okay.
Already.
Now, she does live shows, Sleepwalker, at Baby Castles, February 2nd.
Mm-hmm.
Where's Baby Castles?
Lower East Side, I think.
And you and Buckels will be be doing Between Two Bushes.
Bushes.
Neat.
That would be at Baby's All Right, February 13th.
That's right.
And you're doing it for, let me pronounce this properly, Planted... Parenthood.
It's Planet Hollywood.
Oh, so like they have like fetuses from celebrities on the wall that are autographed?
And we don't want that to stop. And we don't want it to close.
No, nope. Uh-huh.
We're raising money for Planet Hollywood.
So you're raising money for the funerals in Texas?
That's correct.
Okay. Thank you for coming on the show.
Oh, well, I regret it.
That was the longest intro that I've ever done.
Enjoyed it.
I liked it. Yeah. Okay.
By the way, Colin, who is a man.
True.
A white male.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Has the best special.
Yes.
On Netflix right now.
The best special.
It's the best. I watched it the other night. And as you know, I don't like to enjoy other people being talented.
Of course.
Does any of us?
No, right?
No.
The worst.
What's the point?
Right.
Of doing stand-up after you watch Colin. It should just be Colin.
Yeah.
We should stop.
We should
really?
Stop.
Maybe we should
turn
give
up.
Us off.
I watch it. It's just like everybody else is doing something different than what he's doing. It's beyond.
It's so smart.
It's so smart. It's just just find out how to see it.
Film and spiraling now.
I'm sweating.
All right. So I can.
You can retire.
Okay. Barbara Drinkwater.
Oh, God. What a piece of trash.
What a literal piece of garbage.
Let's talk about Barbara Drinkwater.
Let's.
I have gotten into... I worked with Barbara Drinkwater.
Why?
You do? Where?
I was told by a lot of people that Barbara Drinkwater was a genius.
Ew!
Who?
Great. No. Can we say who?
Yeah. Who? What?
My...
Just colleagues.
Colleagues, okay. One of my daughters loves her, thinks she's a role model for women.
Oh! No!
And when I first met Barbara Drinkwater,
I want to know how this goes down.
Yeah.
I thought, she's, very, very nice for about 2 minutes. And then Barbara Drinkwater proceeded to be an absolute pig.
A nightmare.
A literal nightmare.
So, I had said to somebody your age, I'm at a loss to how to deal with Barbara Drinkwater because...
Babs.
Babs Drinkwater because she dominates a room. As a parody of what she thinks
people want to see
in a woman.
Yes.
And I got
abso-fucking-lutely.
So I said to somebody, look, I'm playing out the season here. And I know I'm bad. I'm a white Jewish male. I'm a comedy writer. And it's all my fault. I accept that. And maybe I'm threatened and maybe I'm a sexist. But when I'm in the room with Barbara Drinkwater...
It's not you.
This time, Feldman, it's not you.
It's not you. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
She's a caricature of a person, and I think that she's deeply...
Oh, my God.
I think someone really hurt her.
This is what women would think is, like, really fun. And my manager said that I should be more fun.
And it's hurting us.
Yeah, it is.
Because...
Her whole persona is destroying women, I've decided.
Yeah. The fact that that young people who are, like, woke, look at her... And are like, this is it.
Here we go, guys.
This is what it takes.
Makes me want to kill myself.
She's so negative.
Yeah.
She's never spoken a kind word to me or Buckels. And we've been in the room with her at least 7 times. She does not acknowledge us. She shows up to every comedy function and just leeches on people. But
she's
she
a
doesn't
star fucker.
Do anything.
She does nothing. She brings nothing to the table.
No.
But she is well read, right? And she is smart.
Sure.
Maybe. I don't know.
I think she's pretty smart. That was the thing that was so annoying about her, quite frankly, was that I found her to be brilliant.
Really?
Yeah.
I should say I've never been in the room with her in a creative, like,
sure,
sense, but I have heard from multiple people that they wanted her out of the room.
Yes.
Out of the writing
that she,
room.
Yeah, that she was not, it was, she was not, like, if, like, her ideas weren't received well, she would immediately just start shitting on everybody else.
Mm-hmm.
I just, like, don't appreciate that about somebody.
Yeah, I mean, she was, you know, I noticed working with Barbara Drinkwater that she would shit on everybody's ideas and dominate the room. But I'm, you know, I have an antenna to like, I go on, you know, she's kind of right.
Like, oh.
So my takeaway was, wow, Barbara Drinkwater is pretty effing brilliant, but she has no class.
Hmm. Okay. I say that's fair.
Yeah.
I think you need both.
Yeah.
Otherwise, no one wants to tolerate
right.
your genius.
Right.
Who cares? Who cares?
To circle this back, like I was saying, talking about a while ago, is that I think the idea of, like, the 90s chef genius, who's just, like, the most brilliant, amazing cook in the world, but he throws plates, mm-hmm. and he, like, hurls a plate at your head, and you're like, but his food is incredible. He's a genius. He's an innovator. Fuck that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That is dying.
I agree.
That breed of genius is dying. Nobody's going to put up with plates being hurled at their head anymore because
no.
why would you? There's too many brilliant people out there
yes,
who are nice.
And everybody has tools to be
right.
artists now.
Yeah.
So if anything, you just need to be the most tolerable person.
Right.
In the room. Otherwise, people aren't going
to want
to work with
you. Isn't that like what getting
you.
Hired in like the in like entertainment is? It's just like, would I be willing to spend the next, like, 10 hours in a room
in
with this person?
A day with them,
yeah.
Because everyone has tools. I mean,
yeah.
Feldman's YouTube channel.
Look
you know what I mean?
What a tool.
He's doing those makeup tutorials.
Yeah.
You know?
Okay. I find this is really important to me because I don't mean to get really heavy here, but I think in work, how you treat people is the most important thing.
Absolutely.
That the show or whatever you're making is an accidental byproduct of how you treat one another.
Yeah.
You two ugly-faced whores. Now.
Oh, okay.
This
Great.
Is me. I don't know if you do this, but this is me leaving the studio. This is me slamming the door.
Yep.
This is me walking down the street, hailing a cab. Taxi. I'm getting
Thank
in the cab.
Thank you. That's enough. No more, please.
I'm right. I'm between first and second on the left side. It's great. Thank you so much. Oh,
Thank
a
you.
Chip reader. I put my chip in. I'm far away from here.
Approved. You take it out.
Yeah, yeah.
So, was that horrible? What I did? That was
like,
oh,
he has to, like, get permission.
How you treat one another is the most important thing because
yeah.
I'm obsessed with how you feed yourself, how people feed themselves.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
there's that work is the most important thing in America. It's all we have. And we can't – so – and the plight of all work, all 99%. So when you come to the office or the factory, if, wherever, you have to treat people with dignity and respect. And that, to me, is the biggest sin you can commit in America. Because it's America's, you define yourself by what you do for mm-hmm. a living.
That's the icebreaker question for anything. It's just like, hey, I'm so-and-so. Oh, cool. What do
yeah,
you do?
Yeah. Where do you work?
Yeah. I need to know, I need to pigeonhole you.
I need to understand who you are by understanding, like, what you do for a living. How do you make mm-hmm. it through this?
But right. not only that.
Only,
but,
and that's an American.
That's very, yes. a very American idea.
But universally, it's like, Babs, drink water.
Yeah.
Barbara
no
drink
one's.
Water.
Barbara.
Right. Barbara.
I'm so sorry.
Wow.
I'm disrespecting her by being mm-hmm. so familiar. no one is going to care that she has a show on.
Blah, blah, blah.
Right.
Yeah. We don't want to get into it.
You know?
Right.
No one cares. When you're on your deathbed, It's about, you know, the connections that you made, the way that you treated people.
Yeah, no one gives a shit.
Yeah, and that's what's so sad is that it's just right. like, I would rather be a person that people want to spend time with, you know?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, I don't care.
So, I'm going to push back. I agree with you 100%.
Mm-hmm.
I do.
But you're going to be devil's advocate because
I'm not going to be the devil's advocate.
All right.
Because I'm struggling with this.
Mm-hmm.
I'm struggling with the Barbara Drinkwaters of the world on two fronts. One is, do women have to act as caricatures of men in order to succeed?
No.
I sympathize with the fact that sometimes we do. But I think that when you reach a certain point, that doesn't have to be you anymore. I think that there are certain traits that you should... or women feel like they should, you know, sort of bold and italicize in order to get taken seriously.
Right.
But I don't think that Barbara has anything to prove anymore. So now it's just sort of tasteless.
Right.
I mean, she's already proved herself, you know. But I do think that there's an element of, like, having to be the loudest voice in the room and being brassy or what, you know what I mean?
Are millennials Truvia sluts? I think I'm... You know what Truvia is?
No.
Truvia.
I think I'm getting this right, and I'm no nickname. One of my followers will correct me if I'm wrong. Truvia, I believe, is the AIDS cocktail. And there's a...
What?
I'm making a point here.
Oh, my God.
Make it. Hurry.
Alex, please. Can you look up Truvia just to make sure
can
I
can you
I'm
not?
Here.
Okay.
Like, Alex has to look up what the AIDS cocktail is.
Just making his life hell.
I'm so old. God. And I'm so old. The AIDS cocktail for me was a quaalude in the drink, so he was passed out before you made. Okay.
Okay.
Oh wow.
That's. Alex is just sweating like whole. Oh, he doesn't know what to stop or what to.
You know, I'm just playing a nickname. I don't know who. There's a guy named Nickname who listens to this show from San Francisco.
Shout out.
I don't know who he is. I have a feeling it's...
Andy,
he's the love of your life.
No, I have a feeling it is a very successful comedian who I started with.
Oh really?
Trolling you?
No, he just has a name. He's called himself Nickname. He just knows way too much about
you.
Things that it, a mutual
it's
interest.
Him.
There's just and I so I know he or she is pretending to be somebody else. So,
what are your guesses? Oh, you don't want to call
them
out.
I don't want to
say it. Okay.
So I think it's called a Truvia slut. And these are the young guys who ride bareback now without condoms because they have this AIDS cocktail. And the older...
What is that?
I don't know what that is.
The
what
AIDS is, cocktail?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have a sip of my coffee.
I'm at home. I'm bolting my door. I'm putting the chaining
the door, locking your bedroom
under my covers.
Sure, yeah.
My God.
The reason you can laugh at AIDS and cancer now is it's not no longer a death sentence. It's something. It's you can laugh.
How is cancer not a death sentence?
There was a time when cancer, even though it had a K sound in it, was not a punch word. You couldn't get a laugh saying cancer. Cancer is curable now. It's not a death.
It's treatable.
People laugh treatable. At cancer.
It's not curable.
It's something you can
live with.
Live with.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And AIDS has suddenly become hysterical. I hear it all the time now as a punchline.
Really?
Because not as many people are, you know, dying
from
it.
An epidemic.
And anyway, do you feel vis-a-vis Barbara? I love saying vis-a-vis.
He's writing it down.
Write it down, vis-a-vis. Feldman. Get it down. You'll forget it.
Vis-a-vis. vis-a-vis Barbara Drinkwater, this horrific
human being.
Comedy writer.
Excuse for a person.
Or whatever she is.
Trash can on fire.
The trivia, the young gay guys who have sex without a condom because they know they can go get the medication if they get HIV are resented by older gay men because, you know, we went through the 80s and...
He throws we around pretty loosely.
I do throw we around. That's why I'm wearing my... Hang on, I got the joke.
Oh.
My Depends diapers because I'm making a pun about we.
Do you get it?
When
Lacey?
You have to explain the joke.
Did you get what he said?
Yeah.
That was funny, right?
Yeah,
so,
I love the part where he like,
where he backpedaled and then explained it. That was good.
I like that.
That was a good part.
I could do this forever.
I'm uncomfortable.
I could do 4 hours with you guys. I could do a 4 hour show. Alex, I could do 4 hours with him.
That's great because we get 4 minutes left and we're gone.
Meanwhile, Alex
dies
on his phone. He's on his phone. Text Feldman's like, "Hey, Alex, love these girls," and he's like, "Uh-huh."
sure.
On Instagram.
I circle back. People say I don't know where I'm going. I know where I'm going.
He knows.
I don't need a map.
He knows what he's doing.
Barbara Drinkwater is older than you.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Let that be known, Barbara.
Is she a trailblazer?
No.
Did it? Is she from another generation where she had to act a certain way and clear a path so young? May I call you millennials?
Sure. I do love him. And I hate him.
Hate him so much. Love him.
Do you need to show her respect because she's made it easier for you?
Fuck no.
Oh, man.
Easier for me?
Yeah.
No. I mean, in no way, shape, or form has Barbara Drinkwater made my life easier.
That stupid bitch.
What I love about her is her name.
Love that name.
Mm. Barbara. I do have an element of...
Lacey, fucking don't.
I'm rolling my eyes as I say this. I do...
Ew.
A little bit.
What do you owe her?
I don't owe her anything, but I have an element of
what?
A little... Like, I admire what she did and what she made for herself.
What did she do?
And there hasn't been many examples of the loud, unlikable lady. There weren't many.
Loud, unlikable people.
Yes. The fact is she's not playing a character.
Right.
So personally, and even the work that she puts out, I'm not a huge fan of.
Right.
But that theme of being unlikable and still being the star of the show
as a woman. Yeah, let's not get too specific.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
I mean, the star of the show in terms of just like, you're the spotlight. It's on you. You're not like a secondary character. You're making, you know?
So what you're saying, okay, yeah, I understand what you're saying. You know, I did a roast battle the other night, and this woman said to me, she had to dial it back because she's a very attractive woman. She
Alex goes, oh.
Very attractive. A very attractive comedian. I wasn't paying attention to what she was saying.
Sure.
Why would you?
So attractive.
All right, so I'm gonna fess up.
Mm-hmm.
I'm all over the map. I apologize. I was not making a joke when I said very attractive. And I shouldn't have said that, right? I went there.
Well, what's the story?
I don't know, but I just felt
I don't
like
know. Saying, it doesn't bother
what's
me.
What's the context?
I felt like, I don't know. I just felt obliged to say.
But she was attractive?
That she was attractive.
Oh, yeah. Not right.
Yeah.
Not right.
Yeah, okay. But with Barbara Drinkwater, I think the thing that I just don't feel I get.
By
very...
the way, I think one of you is attractive and one of you isn't. Should I tell you?
Oh, I am. I set my alarm for tomorrow.
I'm
not waking up.
Taking NyQuil
I'm
leaving.
Yeah, I'm
okay.
taking
I'm
it.
Gonna,
yeah,
okay.
A shot
I'm gonna
of NyQuil.
Write down. I'm gonna write down which one of you I think is doable.
And then I'll eat it and I'll shit it out.
Yeah. Excellent. I'll flush it.
And then, we'll play a game. Guess which? No, okay.
Oh wow, worst game ever.
Go ahead. I'm sorry.
No, I think
I gotta ask you. Is that horrible? What I just said? Or is it funny?
It honestly didn't dawn on me, but I do understand why it's like.
What? Wait. What he just said?
Yeah.
No.
Is it horrible?
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, one of us is hotter, of course.
Is it funny? Is it retro? Is it retrograde? Is it reactionary? Where does it fall? If Jezebel were reviewing this right now.
Oh wow.
Well, I don't want to talk about Jezebel.
Okay. Go ahead.
I don't think Jezebel's like
it. I was just saying that I just don't. You know, I think that. I'm sure, you know, Barbara Drinkwater, obviously, intelligent, talented, has obviously done some impressive things. Good for her. I don't think that I have to clap for every woman who stands on stage and tells a joke.
Of course not.
You know what I mean? I just don't think that, like, I don't, you know, and I just don't think that especially being around a lot of these people all the time, she's not nice.
No.
Oh, no.
For no reason. For no reason. Mm-hmm. She's just an asshole.
Yes.
Right.
And it's, I just don't understand why anybody or how anyone could physically get that big of a stick up their ass.
So I watched this documentary on Netflix called...
Did you, though?
Yeah.
Did you really watch it?
Did you really watch it?
You know what? I didn't. I watched I swear to God, I watched half of it and I got bored.
Yeah. Okay.
Did you watch it, Feldman?
But that is watching a documentary, right?
Is it, though?
Is watching half of it and getting bored.
Sure. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then saying you watch a documentary to
your
friends.
Yeah, I watched this really interesting documentary.
That's what
on
that
Netflix
is.
Last night.
I think that he did it right.
Yeah, it's fine.
It's called 13. It's about the 13th Amendment.
Hmm. Oh, I was hoping it was about, like, little girls that are crazy.
Oh, the movie 13 starring Evan Rachel Wood?
And
no bra, no panties.
Love.
And it's about African Americans and slavery. And I got bored because it had nothing to do with me.
Couldn't relate.
Yeah, could not relate.
Oh,
my God.
And somebody said, somebody said that what the 13th Amendment and desegregation and the civil rights movement is about, it's allowing African Americans to be complex human beings. And that I got the shivers when I heard that, because I got malaria. And
I hate that joke.
No, malaria is the black girl I'm dating who made me watch 13.
Thank you.
Wow.
Alex. Is he doing sound effects in there?
Oh, that's good. What was the sound of that? What is that?
Hold on.
Oh, my God.
Wait, is that Debbie Downer?
Yeah.
Love.
You know why they called her so Debbie Downer? She had Down syndrome. It's not funny. I looked into that.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, you're laughing at somebody with...
Wow.
All right, let's
I'm
do,
the monster.
Okay.
Yeah, that's...
So, that you don't... The 13th Amendment is supposed to allow African Americans to be complex human beings. In other words, if you're an African American... And you're suffering from schizophrenia and you're having a meltdown and your social worker is hugging you, the cops should not shoot you. The cops need to understand that, no, there are African Americans who have mental health issues and they're complex.
That's fucked,
and, yeah. You know, not everybody is a magical Negro.
Wow.
So... Women should be allowed to be complex in the workplace. There can be some Barbara Drinkwaters, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And there's room for all. And I
have cried at work many times.
Oh,
yeah.
Sure.
I've yelled at another woman at work because she told me I was taking work too personally.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I is she right for saying that?
But no, I don't think so. I think that it was a show I'd been working on, and it was a very stressful day. Things had not gone great that day, and I sort of like needed a minute to go compose myself in my office, and she came in and sort of said, you know, said, "You know what your problem is that you take work too personally."
Was she older than you?
No, she's younger than me.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
Lacey, you want to
I mean, I know exactly who this is, and I won't say.
I can't. I won't.
But, I mean, you guys are both successful at what you do.
Yeah.
And you getting, you know, you being sensitive about something that hurt your feelings has not impeded you from doing your job.
No.
This person is equally successful and has maybe had a different path. As you know, I mean, both of you are pretty. You say what you mean, you know. You guys are some very down ladies, you know, and I think that works in your favor,
right?
Considering that you're working with a lot of men, I think that it does.
Yeah, wait,
but it has. But you being sensitive that day has not impeded either of you from doing your job.
Should we talk about my character description and a certain secret?
Oh no, we can't. We can't. I'd be killed.
Is it wrong for me to think, going back to calling you comedians instead of comedians?
Mm-hmm. Woof.
Yikes.
We have to?
Yeah.
Okay.
All Am right. I wrong as somebody who's been victimized by the white male hegemony, the overlords?
Sure.
Because, you know, men get abused from this alpha dog crap that goes on.
I'm sure. Yeah.
Yeah.
100%.
We're worse in many ways because we have egos and self-esteem.
Wow. Yeah. And you're complex human beings.
Yes. Yeah. No, I get it.
That was not our birthright.
Is it? I'm asking you this a genuine question. Is it wrong for me to say that I want women to bring their qualities to politics, to the workplace? That there are qualities that women have.
Oh, I don't think that's wrong.
Yeah, why would that be wrong?
I think that we've been
told... I want them to bring their breasts, is what I'm
saying. Sure,
right. Yeah.
Both of them.
That makes sense. Both of them is possible.
And wear tight clothing.
Wow.
Yeah.
Show up, you know.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Absolutely.
Come to work. Really come to work.
Yeah, sure. Ask me a question that you already know the answer to, and I'll explain it to you and make myself feel important. Sure. Yeah. I get it.
Is that... Like, I don't even know, like... if that's even funny anymore when I do, like, just, you know.
I don't know. I think you're playing like a caricature of that person.
Yeah,
and
it's
that
just too
be
easy,
funny.
Though. It's just too easy.
Yeah.
It's lazy, Feldman.
It's lazy.
It's lazy.
Get back to work.
Anyway, yeah. And lazy Jeka is.
That's what they call me at Starbucks. They do.
Lazy?
Lazy, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna stop okay. trying to make these jokes because I agree with you.
Hey.
It's lazy to make those.
It's low hanging fruit, you know. Yeah. It's just been done
right
over.
Where's
and
the
over
conflict?
And exactly. Where's the tension?
But women do bring things to the workplace or politics that they saved Iceland, for example. That Iceland was the first country to go under because of the mortgage crisis, and they put people in jail. They put all the men in jail, and now Iceland is being run by women. You're yawning.
Yeah, this is exhausting. Wow.
So sleepy. I think, I don't know. I think that if Carly were more open, can we cut that?
Carly Fiorina?
Yes. I just shot myself in the foot. Never mind.
Let me ask you about women in the workplace.
Yes.
And then okay. I'm going to say this. Take a nap because this is a long road.
Oh my God.
Alex is hanging himself right now. Here's I think one of the problems that I'm finding. Okay? In the twilight of my senility. Women I know are angry at me, and I'm trying to figure out what I did, what my generation did, and I do accept the blame.
Feldman's eternal life quest.
But let me throw three theories at you, and then you can pick one.
Ooh, just one?
A grab bag?
Yes.
Okay.
I think work is a lie. I think work, defining yourself... by your job, which we all do in America,
right,
is a lie. And I was raised, I was told.
All right, that's boring and obvious. Pass.
And I mean, of course we agree.
That work is a lie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And nobody is happy at their job because work is empty. It's the community is great and making money is great, but in the end, the system that we have set up is a constant disappointment. It's you're constantly getting the rug pulled out from under you, and if you can be part of a team and work together, you can get something out of it. But in the end, work is not how you should define yourself. You should define yourself by who you love, how you love, and how you treat others. And I think a lot of men my age and my father's age figured that out. And I think women are the new suckers for corporate America. That women are being suckered. That the same way gay men and gay women are getting married because heterosexual people have figured out that marriage is complete.
Like tried and true, that it's just inevitably going to disintegrate.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
Last night, this waiter goes, I'm getting married tomorrow. And I go,
That's his vote of confidence.
Right, now I got great. Now I got to give him a 10% tip instead of a 5% tip.
Oh, wow.
And do you think that women are the new suckers for corporate America? That women actually believe that they can define themselves? Because you were told, don't take your job too seriously. Do you think that women...
Not seriously, personally.
Or personally, do you think you're taking it a little... Because I know I have... Do you think you're the new, that you're the new suckers who think, oh, it's all about who I am is work, not
who? No, I just think that it feels, I just know that when I'm not working or when I'm not, I don't think I'm like being a sucker to it. I think when I'm not working or when I'm not part of something that I feel that I'm not like contributing or something, I just don't feel good. I feel lazy and not relevant, and I don't.
Me
it
too.
Doesn't, it doesn't feel good.
I know. Me too.
It's not
like the holidays were depressing, right?
Right. They were awful.
The phone is
ringing.
Lacey
and I spiraled daily.
You just reflect on all the things that you could be doing.
Yeah,
and you're just like in a prison of like having to enjoy family.
And I think that's very absolutely. I think that's very American of us.
Enjoy the holidays.
Yeah, absolutely. I think that. You know, we've spent a shitload of money that we don't even fucking have on gifts that kids are not going to give a flying fuck about. And we are trying to make everyone happy. And hopefully the tree is good enough. And hopefully we have like a big dinner. And hopefully we can all afford to get a bottle of champagne and have a nice night. And then you spent all your money and now you're sitting there and it's like, fuck, I'm behind in work.
Yeah. There's not really a moment of reprieve. It's just a cycle. Like you're supposed to be working toward that moment.
Right.
Where you get to spend the holidays with your loved ones. And
right.
That whole time you're just wishing you were back at work. And right. Vice versa, though.
Maybe people with money get to do that, Lacey. Don't you ever wonder?
Huh.
What's it like?
I wonder.
Don't you wonder?
Mm. Is there a wind chime?
Yeah.
Well, I think the problem for people with money is they're surrounded by people without money. That we, even though we have a 1%, the 1% likes to pretend they're... of the people. A lot of them do, especially the kids, the idiot kids of the 1%. They like to mingle with us.
Mm-hmm.
And
it's like a shitty party.
I like to come out to play once in a while, you know,
they
downstairs. Mean,
they dress down.
I know this great place down on the east side.
They dress down, pretend they don't have a safety net.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden they're at St. Moritz for, you know, for Christmas and then they come back. So it's the problem with not having an official aristocracy. Turn your phone off, please.
It's my dad.
Oh. Is it really?
Yeah. Papa Buckels.
Papa Buckels.
There he is.
Is he okay?
Oh, I'm sure he's fine. He's probably just calling to say hi. Saturday.
Tell him to say hi to the people.
Hey. My dad looks like Wolf Blitzer.
Cool. My dad looks like Woody Harrelson.
Wait, we've been over this. I love it.
Do you talk to your father once a week?
I talk to him like almost every day.
And what about you? Do you talk to her father every day?
Every day. Every night.
That's right.
All right.
Every morning.
What were we just talking about?
Women in the workplace. The 1%?
Oh, money. Yeah,
money.
Money. Money, 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 money. So I think that the curse of being rich is you have to surround yourself with other rich people.
Mm-hmm.
And they tend to be shallow.
And
boring.
And boring. Mm-hmm. And or if you then mingle with the downtrodden... you're living a lie.
Are we talking about the plot to Titanic?
Yes.
Love Titanic.
That's a good
movie.
Do you find this sort of rootless existence meaningful?
Wow. And he really cleans up in that suit.
Turns up like a new penny.
Wow.
Unsinkable Molly Brown.
I would have let Rose just go. Just
wreck
share
you?
The no. door, Rose.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it wasn't
your
difficult,
fucking problem.
Right?
The door's
there
enormous.
There was a lot of room is the thing.
James Cameron, get a smaller door. What's wrong with you? It wasn't believable.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think
what?
That maybe Jack is the one to blame because he was being too chivalrous?
Too chivalrous?
It's like, okay.
Come on, Jack. You knew
relax.
There was room on there. Come on.
Right.
Stop shivering like an asshole. Don't be the victim.
Exactly. And now we have to be a martyr and we have to like
get on the door.
You could have gotten on the door.
Get on the door.
Like my whole life, I'm just supposed to be like, he could have gotten on. Like, I'm so sorry.
I'm just devastated all through elementary school because Jack Dawson died.
That's my identity now.
That's me.
Great.
That's what I grew up with.
Great. It's all about you, Jack.
Perfect.
In the afterlife.
Yeah, cool.
Congrats.
Thank you.
Thank you for letting me out the door.
Good job.
So handsome.
Fuck him.
So money. Here's an article that.
Oh, here we go.
Cleaning out the trash.
Cleaning out the trash. You said something last week,
mm-hmm.
and it stuck with me. And I was very proud of you when you said it, and then you made me laugh. You said to me about the days of being the evil genius are over.
Mm-hmm.
And you just said, Lacey, that we have tools now where everybody can be a genius. The idea
not a genius, but everyone can collaborate and make something.
Yeah.
You know?
And so your behavior has to be perfect. And then you said, I'm so broke.
Yes.
Is that when you put money into the equation?
Yeah.
If you have the money.
I see where you're going with this. Uh-huh.
Where am I going with it?
I don't know. I feel maybe I'm wrong. But I think that, you know, you're forced to work for the creative genius when
you
need
money. If there's money involved, then people then say,
yeah,
you have to eat my shit.
That's the truth. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
But I guess what bothers me is I know that there are some people who don't need to deal with the evil genius. They have the monetary comfort,
the means
to not do it, yet they sit there and take it.
And kiss ass.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And what is that about? And why are you looking at me?
No.
You know.
No, man. No.
Not you.
Not you.
So why do they take it?
I think part of it might be growing up and working in a different generation. I think part of it might be, I know for one thing that sometimes, you know, millennials or people like Lacey and I will work for someone because it looks good.
For sure.
And it opens new doors for you that you didn't know that you, it just opens new doors.
But I mean, we're nobodies willing, and we're not idiots.
Yeah.
You know?
And we're willing to like eat shit for a couple of weeks.
Absolutely.
To know that we have
it. And so this is very important to me, and I don't want to make jokes about this. So I, you know, my dad.
Lacey, stop. I'm so sorry. Laughing.
My dad, you know, World War II veteran, ran Auschwitz. And, you know, he was good at it. It was wrong.
And he was all about the work.
He was all about the work.
Because work will set you free.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
In a Bach right. fry.
Yes.
Arbit Bach fry.
Wow.
That he
we can say that because we're Jewish, by the way.
And I can say that because I hate Jews.
Oh, okay. So. Yeah.
Right.
We're all
no,
same
no,
page.
Same thing.
Mm.
Same thing.
Tomato.
So my father instilled in me. You soldier on. He was a liberal, you know, but he said, you know, if I had problems at school, figure it out. I'm not going to go in. My parents said, we don't care. You know, this teacher is horrible. Well, this is what life is like. So
this is it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is what life is. Yes, your teacher is giving you a bad grade. It's unfair. She made a mistake on the test. If you go in and I'm not going to call your teacher and have her change the grade. You either make your case or don't, but it's up. I'm not going to protect you. So that's my generation. And then a job, you know, if I tell my dad, I can't stand this job, he'd go, who cares?
It's a job.
It's a job.
Job.
You're
yeah.
not supposed to be happy at work. Just go in, do your job.
And leave.
And
yeah.
leave.
Right.
Although he did also say, instill in me the importance of finding work that would be nourishing. And
yeah, because you talked about feeding yourself, right?
Yeah.
And that's probably another way.
Yeah. But I think my generation is, there's a pride of, oh, I didn't get any sleep. I've been working 7 days a week, 80 hours.
Absolutely.
And I'm getting no sleep, and oh, he doesn't stop, or she doesn't stop calling me. And it's just, and there's almost like at dinner, everybody is swapping stories about how horrible their work is. And it's,
these battle scars of how hard you work.
Yeah.
And there's a nobility to that.
Sure.
No?
Yeah.
Yes.
I think so. And I was the same way in college. It was like, ugh, I'm in both main stage productions.
Wow.
I'm taking 18 credit hours and I'm working a full-time job.
My plate is so full.
I'm just so hardworking,
you know?
But I think that that mentality in our generation is starting to be like exhausting. In the term, not exhausting.
So you're
like,
getting
oh.
both. You're getting mixed signals. Your parents, I think,
yes.
are giving you mixed signals.
Yes.
Work. What are those mixed signals?
Well, I think that nobody's that impressed anymore. If you're like just working yourself to the bone. At least I'm not. When somebody's just like, oh, I'm just doing this, it's like, oh, you just sound like you're spread a little thin. Like maybe right. you should take something.
You
off
should
your
take
plate
care of yourself
and actually yeah. do a good job at one of your things.
Like Ariana telling you to sleep.
Yeah, absolutely. but then I also think that there's, you know, one of the phrases that my dad always told me growing up that I really still hold very, is like, he's like, you know, you just keep showing up. You'd be yeah. the first one there in the morning and you'd be the last one there at night. Mm-hmm. And I always did that. And I still do.
Yeah.
I'm the first one there and I'm the last one to leave. I'm, you know, turning on the lights and shutting off the lights and I just keep showing up. And he's like, if you keep showing up, good things will happen. And that's like my work ethic. But at the same time, I think that it's like, it's starting to be, there's a new wave that I think is like coming from our younger than us even, is just being like, no, you have to like take care of yourself. Like, that's ridiculous.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I like, think I'm just short. Like.
Oh, excuse me for 1 second.
Okay.
We'll get to you in a second.
Okay.
Do you think that as you get older, that you begin to say, you know what, I don't need to be there first thing in the morning, first. That as you get older and mm-hmm. you have more confidence, it's not a generational thing, it's just a function of more confidence and aging where you go, oh, you know what?
Yes. I think I'm starting to get to a point where it's like, you know what, I don't feel obligated to be there, be the first one there.
How old are you again? Do you mind if I ask you?
Yeah, I'm 28.
And how much do you weigh?
God damn it. But this is the second time he's done this joke, by the way.
I can see that. Yeah. It was tired. The delivery was tired. It sounded rehearsed.
What were you going to say?
I was going to say that. I was going to say what you said about just getting older. But I think there's also something to just being kind of tired. Like, you get, not that I'm, like, exhausted, but just it's tiring to keep that up. And when you get older, you just sort of go, like,
you realize
I don't
how
really
it's
have
bullshit.
The capacity to do that anymore.
And then you listen to these kids at NYU, and you're just like, oh, God.
Yeah.
So glad I'm not 23
anymore. It just seems like another
anymore.
Facade, you know? Like, yeah. you either have to be who you are. You just get to the point where you just have to be who you are. And
yeah,
if who you
is
are
it,
is not, like, a workaholic, then you let that go. You're
right.
not trying to impress
If this isn't
anyone,
good enough for
anyone.
You, then, like, great. Like, yeah. I can do other things. Like, that's fine.
Right. Not that you don't show up and work hard still, but just
right.
that's not your MO, is like looking like you're the one working the hardest.
Yeah. Would you work for somebody like Barbara Drinkwater, Lacey?
Oh.
If Barbara Drinkwater were truly gifted. If you thought Barbara Drinkwater was a genius.
Yeah.
Would you put up with all of her crap?
Yes. At this juncture, yes, I would. I would. I think that I'd have, yeah. you know, I definitely learned. There's always something
to learn. To,
yeah. There's always something to learn. And also, I'm not a Barbara Drinkwater. I know that. You know, I'm not that yet.
But could Barbara Drinkwater turn you into a Barbara Drinkwater?
How so?
I don't think she can.
In terms of, like, how I treat people?
Well, could Barbara Drinkwater maybe teach you if she were a genius?
Mm.
And I happen to think Barbara Drinkwater may be.
A genius? I think
she's
Barbara's pretty, smart.
I think she's very smart.
She's smart. There's no arguing that.
She had her.
No one's arguing her talent or her intellect.
Her emotional IQ.
Her emotional IQ is zilch.
Yeah.
It's lacking.
Yeah. Yeah. I
Nobody's
mean,
arguing
I would,
that she's an intelligent, creative human being.
I would try to take the best of Babs's qualities and
yeah.
instill those
best
in myself.
Best of Babs.
Yeah, the best
but
of Babs.
You,
sure.
Do you need to have those qualities to be, you know, speaking of Babs, Barbara Streisand, for example.
Oh, yeah. Love
now,
her.
I love Barbara Streisand.
Love
her.
Love.
In fact, I'm rediscovering Barbara Streisand.
Wow.
As he always is.
As you do with Barbara,
there
though.
He is.
Always got to rediscover.
Look at him. Arms out.
Arms out. Ready.
What? I think she's Barbara? Fabulous. I mean, what?
What? She really is.
I think she's fabulous. She's been a role model to me. Why does that sound gay? No, I didn't. You were.
I'm not even going to. I can't. Lacey,
she
how
can't.
Are you?
Oh, I'm good. I'm actually, you know what?
You were making fun of me because I like to dress up like Barbara.
Yeah.
And ride the subways till 4 a.m.
I think if you did drag, you'd be more interesting.
Yeah, that's a really fair point.
Is it fair to say that Barbara Streisand has a lot of Barbara Drinkwater's qualities?
Is that true?
Yeah.
I mean, I've never been in a room with Barbara Streisand.
No, you know what?
Streisand.
I will. Yeah, fair enough. I've never been in a room with Barbara Streisand. But Babs,
Monster?
I will say that the way that Babs comes off, it's not because she feels above you. It's because she's somehow threatened and feels insecure. And that
like
at any moment,
pushed out.
Barbara Drinkwater can be pushed off of her little pedestal and somebody else can take her spot.
But there,
as anyone does, but you
right.
can, she
Who are we talking about?
Drinkwater.
Babs oozes of sort of desperate insecurity to me. And maybe I find that uncomfortable because it's a quality I relate to. Mm. And that's why it makes me uncomfortable.
In a work situation, do you see Barbara Drinkwater differently than, say, I would see Barbara Drinkwater?
Yes.
What am I getting wrong about Barbara Drinkwater?
I don't think you're getting anything wrong. I think you're different people and have a different perspective.
Yeah.
You're an old man. Lacey's a gorgeous young girl.
Oh.
Look
yeah,
at her,
the
guys.
Listeners should know I'm gorgeous.
She's a mermaid. You okay. should all
I mean,
know that.
Yes. They can follow me on Instagram.
Yeah, for sure. She's a shemadel.
A what?
A shemadel.
Shemadels.
A shemadels.
Yeah.
Here's
Alex just getting it.
It's a callback. I swear to you, I saw She Model.
Because you're sick in the head.
Feldman needs help.
You're a She Model.
There's
no
argument
there.
The way that I was constructing the sentence was, she's
yeah, right?
a threat, she's this,
she's
okay.
the model.
If you're as mentally ill as I am, this is how I would
oh
read
God.
This. She's a triple threat, a threat to others, herself, and She Models.
We're reading this again.
That's, I mean,
And
fair.
You're a comedy writer, so I figured you were making fun of She Models.
Because that's what comedy
that's
is,
your
right?
brand.
Because that's what, yeah. Did a lot of digging on me and my kind of, what I do in my
Looked
work.
Looked her up on Wiki.
Sure. You
found
can just
nothing.
Make that grand assumption.
So
sweeping assumptions.
There is a man named Galen Buckwalter. Don Hazen from Alternet wrote about this guy. And Galen Buckwalter is doing research about acute financial stress. And it's like PTSD that Americans have acute financial stress, which is akin to PTSD in that it's all-consuming, both physically and emotionally.
Mm-hmm.
Not having money is as bad as killing 42 Viet Cong in
wow.
Saigon
Whoa.
In
I gotta
1968.
Go.
So you don't have to go to Vietnam. You should just, you know,
be yourself.
In America, everybody gets PTSD now.
Wow.
That's terrifying.
Well, but in all seriousness, it's obviously not like going to Vietnam.
Right.
But
oh yeah, it's bad.
It's the worst.
And people don't talk about financial stress in the United States.
It's because
States.
It's impolite.
It's impolite.
But that's
and also
what,
people
that's
are
what I was taught growing
people
up.
Get embarrassed.
You don't talk about money.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
Money, politics, or religion.
Mm-hmm. Right. And who benefits if Americans don't talk about money?
The government.
And the people who control the government.
That's right.
So suss that out. Tease that out.
Hmm.
I think that everyone is struggling a lot more than we all sort of let on. I mean, Lacey and I are constantly joking about how just like our credit and debit cards are just like a lottery. It's like, hope this one works.
I just look at in the eyes of the cashier like a deer in headlights. Like, what am I gonna go there?
Are we gonna do it?
Do I
and
get to eat today?
And it's to a point where I came to New York pretty comfortable. I obviously am, you know, doing my fucking best, trying to do everything that I want to do. And you just kind of like get to a point where you just like literally have no money. And it's so scary.
And whose fault is that?
That's absolutely my fault.
Really? So what were you wearing?
I can't budget for sure.
What were you wearing?
Well, I will say when I first moved here, I was a bartender for a while. And I didn't know. No one really explained to me that they don't take taxes out. So I got a tax bill at the end of the year for $12,000. I
I had nowhere near.
And nobody told you this.
Nobody told me to save money.
What they say is personal responsibility. This is how the victim is blamed. They say, well, if you're too stupid to know that they don't take the money out of it, you have to pay. If you're too stupid, you shouldn't have bought that house.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a system that's in place,
right?
Yeah,
to create indentured servitude.
Mm-hmm.
It's a conscious decision made by the government and Wall Street to suck you in to student loans.
Mm-hmm.
Student loans are—it's a bigger debt than the mortgage,
right?
Yeah,
more people are about to default on their student loans than their mortgages. You don't think when there's $1.4 trillion of student debt out there,
right?
And Wall Street benefits from that debt.
Well, I didn't.
You don't think they're consciously keeping you in the dark so you don't understand?
Right. And then you're taught to just feel bad, right? Like you said, like
and
if you were too
fault.
Dumb.
I literally woke up in a cold sweat last night because I realized I haven't been able to pay my monthly tax payment for the past 2 months.
And whose fault is that?
I would assume mine.
Is it so deeply ingrained in us that
it's
we really just
fault.
Believe this?
It's not your fault.
Because I really do. I'm just like, you're so bad at money.
You're
not
so
making
awful.
Okay.
This is you.
This is how you're tricked by.
Is he going to do a magic trick?
No. Okay.
This is paper. It lights on fire.
If you met me, I'm holding a piece of paper, Lacey. Mm-hmm. Before I ask you to read it.
Okay.
I'm going to hand it to you. And then if you were to meet me for. Would you assume that as a 58-year-old man that I'm a responsible adult?
Oh, I mean, just upon meeting you or knowing you now?
But it would just show the way I present. I have a button-down shirt.
I would. I would think that.
I have a nice button-down shirt.
Nice. Okay.
Responsible adult, right?
Yes. Sure.
I have a briefcase.
Yeah, that's true.
That's true.
He does carry a briefcase.
I carry a briefcase.
When describing him to the producers when I was like, this guy, I was like, you know, the guy that dresses a little too nice for this job.
Right, the serial killer.
The schmuck.
Yeah, the schmuck, the schmo, you know.
I do dress nicely.
You do dress nicely.
Because I'm old.
You and RJ always. No, RJ dressed nicely too.
Yeah, but
RJ always had like a button down.
But when you're the oldest person in the room.
You're not the oldest person in the room.
Yes, I am.
Beckman's not older than you?
I don't know.
Like I said.
Okay. What do I care about before you? What's my one passion other than picking up young runaways and bringing them to my mother's basement and
begging them not to press charges?
Yes. What my passion is government, politics.
Ralph Nader.
I talk on the show about reading the New York Times. Blah, 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 blah. That's what I read the letter that I just got. 58-year-old man.
Board of Elections.
Uh-oh.
Dear voter, we have received your absentee ballot for the general election held on November 8th, 2016. We could not count your vote because it was not in compliance with election laws.
Shut.
They've checked. The ballot was not postmarked by November 7th. You didn't get it in on time. You didn't vote. Oh, my God.
Now, I got this today. I don't remember.
You got that today?
Yeah. I don't remember, you know, when I or how I delivered my absentee ballot. I may have said to somebody, can you
mail this, please?
Yeah.
Oh. So you didn't know until today?
So whose fault is it that I didn't know that ballots not postmarked by November 7th, the day before the election? I mean, whose fault is that? Is that mine?
To commiserate with you a little bit here, I called to figure out where my voting station was to vote, and I called and they couldn't find me in the system. And I was like, definitely registered to vote. They looked for me. They're like, we have a Kristen Buckels here born in 1963. Is that you? I went, no. I was born in 88. Oh, they looked for it. It was my record. Born in 1963, and I said, okay, well, where's my voting station? Like, your voting station is in Manhattan. I was like, okay, great. And I was like, do I just show my ID? And they're like, yeah, but you need to change your birth year. And I said,
what?
Okay, then change my birth year to 88. And they said, well, it's going to take a month to process.
So I couldn't vote because my birth year was wrong.
And whose fault is that?
That's fucking theirs.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
I was livid.
Wow. But I would say if I were trying to keep you from voting, you should have taken care of this, you know.
They would have guilted me and said I should have taken care of this months ago.
Yeah, if you cared about the system.
Right.
But they don't want you to vote. Hmm.
1963. How do you fuck that up?
Yeah. So
1963.
And what could you have done to be more prepared for that?
Right.
Calling a month in advance to see where my voting poll was.
Wow.
But so here I didn't vote in this most important election. I didn't get to vote. And I'm not going to take responsibility for this. I think that they don't want people of color like me to vote. We're getting the wrap. I could keep going. I'm having fun, Alex. But
heavy.
I know we have to wrap it up. Yeah, financial stress is.
But are
awful.
You okay? That's really shitty.
What?
Yeah.
That's devastating that you just found out today, especially after, you know, the outcome.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, it's New York.
To be fair, millions of people voted in the other direction, and that didn't matter either.
Yeah, they're not really. So financial stress is. They figure out. I hate to use the term rape, but Wall Street is raping this country. And they have figured out how to blame you for being raped. That's the system. And stop blaming yourself for your financial distress, because all the jobs.
Lacey and I are crying.
all the good jobs have been decimated by Wall Street.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
There are no jobs in this country. There just aren't. They are full-time jobs that really are part-time salaries. I've traveled around this country, and I kept looking. Where are the jobs? Where is the work? There's no work in this country. There is no opportunity in America. And even though Bernie says it, he's considered on the fringe. The fact is, we will look back. Because the Republic, I believe, has ended.
Mm-hmm.
I think Trump, this is the Cromwell period. I don't know where we're at historically. But we will look back and say, all our freedoms that we thought we had, we really didn't have. And we underestimated the financial distress of 99% of Americans. And that's why Trump was able
to get
in office. Yeah. To get into office and blitzkrieg our nation with decimation of our liberties and the looting of our treasury, because it's going to be every person for themselves. You look really pained.
Yeah.
It sucks.
My family.
Yeah.
My whole family. I was like the black sheep of my family.
For hating Trump.
Yeah. But I know that they were just terrified.
It's
stupid,
but terrified.
There's a mass psychosis. Enough of a mass psychosis going on. Not all of us, but there's a mass psychosis going on in this country right now that will kind of be like a wildfire. More and more people are going to get more and more scared and not speak up. And he is going to loot our country. And because everybody's broke and frightened,
mm-hmm.
you're going to go, well, I just better take care of myself, which is exactly what they want.
Yeah.
They want us to just be individuals mm-hmm. as opposed to a community. And we're a community.
Right.
The most dangerous thing that you can tell Americans is that we're all interconnected and that a rising tide lifts all boats. So we got to wrap it up, but here's my message for my listeners. If you're financially stressed, and we all are, don't beat yourself up. It's not your fault. And if you're out of work, you have time to find out who your congressman is and follow what's going on in Washington, D.C., and your state legislatures. And I know you all hear this, and it's trite, but it's true. Use your time wisely. Study civics, because we need a new republic. And civics is really interesting. It's really interesting how a bill becomes law. It's really interesting what they're doing in Washington, D.C. to you, and you should pay attention to it. My last question to my guests, this has been so much fun.
I love.
Peak TV. Peak TV. I keep hearing peak TV. Peak TV.
Yeah.
I try to watch peak TV.
What are you watching?
What you watching there? Peaks?
Twin Peaks.
Twin Peaks? Twin Peaks.
Ain't so good. And I can't help but think that there's a myth about peak TV. And I'm going to say something sexist.
Oh, of course.
The shocker of the evening.
I think women should belch in public. But that queef was unacceptable.
Wow.
What?
Such a sharp noise.
This has been great. Somewhere to be. I've already taken my shot of NyQuil and I've been put
I'm
to
on
bed.
NyQuil. I have been this entire time.
This is a fever dream.
This is just anecdotal. But I noticed that women watch too much television.
Good night. Wait, what? That's fair.
Women watch
too much
television.
Dance, moms.
I'm wrapping
dance,
it up.
Moms.
Am I right? Go ahead. Go ahead, Alex. Help me out here. They watch too much. You walk into a woman's apartment, their home, the TV is constantly going.
I wish you every could time see I go doing. On a date.
Huh?
Every time I go on a date, all they talk about is TV this. Have you seen the show? Have you seen this? Have you seen
TV's
that?
TV's so fun.
It's mind-numbing. Mind-numbing. Anyway.
No, you know what? I will say, when my boyfriend's not home and I'm just like home alone, I have the TV on.
I think there's something.
I like noise.
You like noise. Women have to turn off their effing TV. Stop watching television.
No, I won't.
You watch and you take pride in garbage. You know it's garbage.
I love garbage.
Dance moms, dance moms.
It brings me so much joy. We love dance moms. Can
love
we talk
so
about
much.
Dance moms? We've just been waiting for you to ask about dance moms, and you haven't.
It's our favorite
and
show.
It's like we have all these stories
to say.
All these fun facts.
So worried about Maddie.
My God, what's happening to Maddie?
I know. Nia and Cameron, the matchup. Are you kidding me?
Where did Chloe go?
Where did she go?
Oh my God,
love her.
Where do you weigh in on dance moms?
What is dance moms?
Abby Lee Miller.
Yeah. She's this tyrant of...
Save your tears for the pillow, Feldman.
Yes.
You could do benefit from this.
She's gorgeous. She's a tyrant of a woman who bosses around these like 8-year-old kids who
it's the best.
Dance morning, noon, and night. And then the moms that their health is just like hanging in... Their mental
just
health.
Just hanging in the balance.
Mm-hmm. Depending on where their kids fall on the pyramid that she does every week.
Saying
who's like the best in
Nothing's
the class.
Better.
It's the best.
Okay,
nothing's better.
I could watch this if we were doing like a sketch. I would watch enough of it to say, okay, now I can write the sketch.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But you're emotionally
invested.
I've rewatched season one. I'm starting to rewatch season two. I'm watching season 7 as it airs.
Defend yourself.
You don't.
No.
Buckles don't.
I won't.
Defend yourself.
I can't.
Don't you dare. Don't you have something that just brings you joy?
Just like some sort of trash.
No, life isn't about joy.
Are you kidding me? I love it so
much.
There's
no such thing as joy.
Oh wow.
This is joyous for me. I like this, but it's also, you know.
Also trash.
Stimulating?
Yeah.
But don't you watch garbage and reflect on your life?
No, never, never.
I hate this.
I should read you. I'm under constant psychiatric observation.
As you should be.
I am. I was just telling a friend that I don't think I've done 1 week without checking in with my shrink.
Oh.
And
a week?
I mean, who honestly today has the balls to not see a therapist?
Yeah, right? You
who
don't
are
see
you?
A therapist?
Yeah.
Oh, good for you.
Ooh.
Ooh. Wow.
So I can't function without just checking in.
That adds up.
But I've kind of...
Do you just poke them on Facebook? What do you do?
Well, I don't want... But I'm very rigid. I mean, I've actually looked at, like, Ben Franklin's 12 virtues. I was reading them. I think they're 12 virtues of how you should live your life.
Okay.
I think I'm more virtuous than Ben Franklin. Not more successful, not as brilliant.
Buckels, did what? You just hear what
I
he
think
said?
I lead a more virtuous life than Ben Franklin.
I don't know. I have to pee. It's time to go. Like,
wow.
I've peed 5 times. What's your problem? All right, we got to wrap it
more
up.
More virtuous than... That is the perfect thing to...
And it's not... Nobody likes me.
That, yes. Well yeah. Good night. That's it.
Yeah, that's
so
it.
To wrap it up. It
thank you, David Feldman Show.
It would not be virtuous for me to watch Dance Moms.
Why it would be, are you so concerned about
because it's
being
not
virtuous.
Industrious. It's wasteful of time.
That's not true.
But that's why you're boring. You know what
I
mean?
I know. I agree.
It's
I
like, agree. Yeah,
that's why all,
sure,
of,
yeah,
that's why all of your jokes are dick jokes.
Okay. Can I make... All
because that's all you
panicked.
We've seen
all of them.
Really?
That queef joke was pretty fast.
Okay,
he was quick.
That was
Alex,
quick.
Can you just like turn it off? Is that right, possible?
Can you turn off his mic?
Can I wrap it up? I'm gonna wrap it up.
Wrap it up.
All right. So,
Jesus
Lacey
Christ.
Jeka, how do people follow you, Lacey Jeka?
Down the street on Instagram.
Hey, Wendy's.
I do get followed down the street.
That's true.
You
in Harlem.
Catch Lacey's live shows, and Kristen Buckels will be with you at Baby Castles February 2nd.
Not at Baby Castles.
I won't be at Baby Castles.
Sleepwalker at Baby Castles.
Yes.
That's February 2nd.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Two of you will be at Baby's All Right February 13th.
What can I say? I'm a baby.
Also my birthday.
From a baby
Planned
girl.
Parenthood.
Yes, that's right.
Also my birthday. And Lizzie's birthday.
Yeah.
It's our birthday bash.
Okay, people should give to Planned Parenthood.
Yes. For our birthdays.
For our birthdays.
And then, you know, if they want to give us, like...
An extra gift, also
a
fine.
Gift card. Or
yeah.
Okay.
Alrighty, that's funny.
Nice bottle of wine, you know.
Whatever. No, but people should give to Planned Parenthood.
They should.
They should.
They do good work.
Mm-hmm.
They really do.
Do.
And, okay, so... And Kristen Buckels, how do people reach you?
You can go to Lacey and I's website, twobushes.com. We're reachable through there. You can follow me on Instagram at Kristen Buck.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And I will be obviously at that show.
Great. And and again, this has been so much fun. And
thank you so much.
So let me wrap it up by
we're
telling
adorable.
Listeners. I want to ask my listeners to do something. Okay. We have a YouTube channel.
Again with the YouTube.
It's audio.
Is it one of those things, you know, what's it called? ASMR?
Oh, I don't know.
Okay.
What is ASMR?
It's when, it's like porn, but for people that just like little sounds.
Oh.
Like they get off by just like a little, like rubbing a cotton ball.
Oh, why? Yeah.
Is that what your YouTube channel is?
No, but I like that channel. There are certain sounds where you get all tingly.
Yeah.
It works with me.
Oh.
Yeah. I will talk about that from... Is it?
That's
know,
next time.
Next time. I'm wrapping it up. I want to ask
corner.
My listeners to do this.
Okay.
We have lots of listeners, and they're very industrious.
Okay.
And it's the new year, and I want to ask people to join Team Feldo any way they can help.
Mm-hmm.
Any way they can help. Because we've been doing some really important shows. The show that we did on Israel just amazed me in terms of the response. People want to learn... They want to laugh. They want to listen. And I was just stunned by the people who thanked me and listened. It's one of our most downloaded episodes where we just explained Israel with no arguing, just facts and love.
Dope.
So what I'd like my listeners to do, if there's anybody out there who wants to take audio, download this as an MP3. You know how to do it if you have these skills. Drag it into... either PowerPoint, Final Cut, Premiere, and add visuals to accentuate the show. It could just be stills. It can be public domain footage. Add visuals to the audio and post it to YouTube. And then I, in turn, will promote it on my YouTube channel. And to my listeners, and that way.
Well, a lot of steps. You know.
There are people out there. If you want to do that, please do that for me. It's a great way to help the show. If you don't have money to become a premium subscriber, do some effing work for me.
Wow. Yeah. Nickname.
Yeah, nickname.
Whoa.
I think I know who nickname is. Okay. And follow me on Twitter. Friend me on Facebook. Go to the David Feldman Show website. Do all your Amazon shopping via the David Feldman Show website. For $5 a month, you can become a subscriber.
Is this for real?
Gain access to all our premium content. We have a great website.
Is the sun is down. Like, I don't know. All the light was just drained from the world. Okay.
From the Showbriz studios in downtown Manhattan.